हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, साई राम। वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड्स 10 ज्योमेट्री क्लास। इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म वन एक्टिविटी ऑन द टॉपिक कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। सो चिल्ड्रन, डू यू रिमेंबर व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स यू हैव लर्न इन कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री चैप्टर? सो वी हैव लर्न डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला, देन सेक्शन फॉर्मूला, देन area of triangle, right? So in today's activity we are going to verify this distance formula by small activity method. So let me quickly revise what is this distance formula, how you use this distance formula. So suppose any two points, say P and Q, are given in a plane of paper whose coordinates are 2, 3. Coordinates of point P are 2, 3. Consider it as x1, y1, and the coordinates of Q, say 4, 1. Consider it as x2, y2. So distance PQ is given by the formula square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Then what we do? We have x1, y1, x2, y2 with us. Substitute the value, then simplify it. So after simplification, we will get, let me simplify further. So this is square root of 2 into 2 is 4 plus minus 2 into minus 2 is again 4. So this is square root of 8, and the answer is 2 root 2. 8 can be split up as 4 into 2, square root of 4 is 2, so 2 root 2 units. Okay, so we will not go in detail, this you have already learned. So now let us verify this distance formula through activity method. So let us proceed. So note down this. The aim of our activity is to verify the distance between any two points on graph paper using distance formula by activity method. Okay, now next point is prerequisite knowledge. What does it mean? The previous knowledge. What are things you should know to do this activity? So you should know plotting of points on the graph paper. This you have already learned in 9th standard in coordinate geometry chapter. Then distance formula, just now we have discussed. Then calculating square roots using the method of long division. This method is useful when your answer is not a perfect square, and if you want to find its square root, then you have to follow this long division method which you know. Now after this, next point is material required. So children, for this you need 1 cm by 1 cm graph paper, pencil, ruler and eraser. I would like to mention one thing, children, if you don't have graph paper at home, don't step out. You can use any blank sheet or blank paper and draw Cartesian plane on that paper. How to draw Cartesian plane? Draw two mutually perpendicular lines. Horizontal line we call it x-axis, vertical line we call it as y-axis. Their point of intersection is origin. To the right side of origin along x-axis we write all positive integers, to the left side we write negative integers, and along y-axis in upward direction we write positive integers and downward direction negative integers. Okay, so you can plot this Cartesian plane on any blank paper, or you can use your old journal also. So but if you have graph paper, make use of it. Then comes procedure. So this procedure I will tell afterwards. Before this, let me show you observation table. How to prepare observation table. So let us proceed. So here it is, observation table. So in first column, coordinates of point A, say x1, y1. Then second column, coordinates of point B, say x2, y2. Then we have calculated distance AB using distance formula, and that calculation part you have to do in procedure, and that value you write here and consider it as A. This is that A. A value is what? The answer which you will get after using distance formula. Then next column, distance AB using ruler. So you have to plot these two points A and B, these two points, on the graph paper or on Cartesian plane, and you have to actually measure the distance between these two points with the help of scale, and that value you write here in this column and consider it as B. Now last column, you compare both the value by using formula and then by using ruler. So what you will find? You will get both the values equal. So in this way we can prove distance formula by activity method. So I have given two sets of points here. I'll give you the detailed method for first set, and similarly you proceed for second set of points P and Q. Same method you apply on the same graph paper or same Cartesian plane. Now let us go back to the procedure. So in procedure here, so take Cartesian plane or graph paper. Let us plot the points. First point was point A, whose coordinates are -2, 1. So that -2 and 1 will come here at this point. So here is your -2, 1. Then point B has coordinates 1, 5, which will come here. Okay, so this is your point A, has coordinates -2, 1, and here is your point B, has coordinates 1, 5. Now you join these points A and B with the help of scale. So in this way you join, and with the help of scale you measure this distance AB and you write this in the observation table as B. Right, now let us proceed. Now under the heading procedure, you do distance formula. Okay, so here now by distance formula, distance AB apply distance formula. Formula is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Now substitute the values. Substitute values here. So the coordinates are -2, 1 and 1, 5. So 1, x2 is 1, minus of -2, that means +2. So 1 + 2 the whole square plus. Then next y2 is 5 minus -2, 1. So right. Now let us simplify. So you will get 2 + 1, 3 square plus 5 - 1, 4 square. So this you will get square root of 9 plus 16 is 25, that is equal to 5 unit. So all these things you have to show under the heading procedure. So with the help of scale you will get one value, and you should get same value by using distance formula. So all these things you will write in procedure. Understood? So here using distance formula, then using ruler, so on comparison you will see A is equal to B, and hence the conclusion is, thus the distance formula is verified through activity method. So isn't it simple? So I hope you all will do this activity. You have to do it, it's compulsory, right? So please do it. And graph paper is not compulsory, you can draw it on the blank paper, right? Any assignment sheet, blank paper, yeah, or old book or old journal, if you have, you can use it. So that's all. We'll meet in the next period.